Today we have to discuss the maintenance of switchgear. First we have to discuss what is the switchgear. The apparatus used for controlling, regulating, switching on or off the electrical circuits in the electrical power system is known as switchgear. The switches, fuse, circuit breaker, isolator, relay, current and potential transformer, indicating instrument, lightning arrestor, control panel, these are the examples of the switchgears. Switchgears are very important component in the electrical field because it controls the equipment, it protects the equipment from the fault condition as well as controlling the various parameters of the equipment as well as for the measuring purpose as well as for the protection purpose. Switchgears are very important component. We have to discuss the maintenance of the relay. What is the relay? A relay is a very important component which sends the fault present or fault occurs in the system and it gives the signal to the circuit breaker that you should operate and isolate the equipment from the faulty condition. Then what is the inspection or what are the maintenance we have to do on the relay? According to the time basis, we have to do the maintenance. Suppose we have to see the annual inspection. In that annual inspection, we have to check the general inspection, no broken glass parts, no or loose or missing parts. We have to check it, or dirt decomposition on the relay, we have to clean it. Check the tips, register setting and other adjustment against the relay data sheet. We have to check it. Then we have to check or examine the moving parts of the relay and we have to examine the relay setting according whether it is properly working or not, or we have to checking the moving part, it is properly moving or not properly, we have to check. Then examine the heating of oil and resistors, we have to check it. Then we have to discuss related to the maintenance of relay. When a relay fails to operate, then we have to check for the improper control voltage. If voltage is less to the relay, then it will not be operate. Dirt and grease or gum on the contact or moving parts, because of that moving part is does not move properly. Then bending of moving parts, because of that it does not move properly. Then corrosion or deposit on the metallic parts, that is corrosion of metal parts, because of that it does not operate properly. Then loose connection, because of that proper supply is not provided to the relay and it does not operate it. Then improper spring tension, because of that moving part is does not move properly and does not proper tension will be provided to the spring. Because of that it does not operate and it will be fails to operate the relay. Next one is the maintenance on the lightning arrestor. In that we have to check the connection to the earth should be short. Then lightning housing need to be checked periodically for cleaning purpose. If dirt will be accumulated on it, we have to clean it. Before handling the lightning arrestor, make sure that the line is de-energized and we have to take permit to work has been obtained from higher authorities for doing the maintenance on the lightning arrestor. The next one is the maintenance of circuit breaker. In that we have to consider the oil circuit breaker. Then in that we have to check the bushing and we have to, if dust will be accumulated on it, then we have to clean the bushing whenever it is needed. Then we have to check the oil level in the circuit breaker monthly. If the oil level is low, we have to add the oil in the circuit breaker, or we have to check why the oil level is lower in the circuit breaker. Then we have to taking the sample of oil for testing from the tank of the circuit breaker quadraturally or after every 6 tripping. We have to check the dielectric strength of that oil. Then we have to check the contacts as per manufacturer instructions are available or not. According to that, we have to make the contacts of the circuit breaker. Next one is the maintenance of the LT circuit breaker, that is low tension or low voltage circuit breakers. In that, we have to check the general tuning of the circuit breaker. General cleaning of the circuit breaker. We have to clean the circuit breaker properly, and we have to check the oil level. If it will be low, then find the reason why the low oil level in the circuit breaker will be low, and we have to add the oil in the circuit breaker. Then we have to check the visual inspection, that is enclosure of the circuit breaker, contactors, relay and joints of the circuit breaker. We have to check properly. Then maintenance of oil circuit breaker. In that we have to check the moving contact and fix the contacts of the circuit breaker. During checking the main and moving contact, we have to file the contacts with the smooth file if badly pitted, and clean them with emery cloth and then with the fine cloth. If the contacts are burned, then we have to replace them. This will be carried out quadraturally in case of heavy duty, and we have to carry it out yearly in case of normal duty. The next one is the connecting rod and lever. Then in that we have to inspect all the pins, screws, nuts and tighten them properly. If it is found loose, then lubricate them with proper grade heavy machine oil, and it will be carried out half yearly basis. Then arc control device. We have to check the arc control device for carbon deposit. If deposit on it, then we have to remove it with the blunt edged tool and wash the surface with kerosene oil. Replace the burn plates. Replace the whole assembly for better performance. Then it will be carried out on the yearly basis for the normal duty. The next one is the closing and tripping mechanism. We have to check it and operate the circuit breaker by hand to see it proper and correct mechanism operation. Lubricate the closing mechanism with a recommended grade machine oil. Use firm smooth fabric for cleaning purpose. Replace worn out parts, and this will be carried out yearly. The next one is the insulating oil. We have to check the condition of the oil and take the sample of oil to test it for its correct dielectric strength of the oil, and it will be carried out in quadraturely basis in case of heavy duty, and we have to carry it out yearly basis in case of normal duty. Then we have to check the oil gauge, inspect the level of the oil in the gauge. Top it with the dehydrating oil. If level is found low, then we have to add the oil, and it will be carried out quadraturely. The next one is the insulator. Inspect the porcelain and bushing for crack and breakage, and replace the broken units. The cracked porcelain causes the leakage, and cracked bushing allows the leaking oil. Clean also the dust and carbon, because it lowers the insulating resistance and causing flashover, and it will be carried out half yearly. Then relay setting. Check all the relay for correct operation with relay testing set half yearly. Then contact resistance. Check the contact resistance and record them yearly. Then indicating devices. Check the indicating devices and lamps. If found defective, you have to replace it or correct them, and it will be carried out yearly basis. The next one is the maintenance of the air circuit breaker. In that we have to first inspect the earthing contact, then clean the contact surface with fine cloth and petrol. Do not lubricate them, and it will be carried out quadraturely. Then bus bar. Tighten the joints if any loose joint is found, and it will be carried out half yearly. Then main contacts. File the contacts. Clean the surface with petrol or recommended chemical, and lubricate with the suitable lubricant like as Vaseline if necessary, and it will be carried out half yearly. Then visible brake. Clean with the petrol and lubricating with the Vaseline, and it will be carried out in half yearly. Lubricating parts. Cleaning of dust and dirt accumulated on the insulated part, and it will be carried out half yearly. Then bearing and joints, clean the rusted bearing and joints with the petrol and re-grease the bearing with the proper grease. It is yearly. Then earthing, check the earth connection, its continuity, and tight the connections if found loose, and it will be carried out in half yearly. The next one is the maintenance of electrical isolator. In that, we need to clean the support insulator body with removing the salt, cement, acid fumes if accumulated on it. Also, we need to inspect the contact surface. If we found any abnormalities, we must immediately replace the same with the new one, or we have to repair it. If the sign of burning is very small, we can remove those by rubbing with the sandpaper. Then also we must check the proper alignment of the contact rods during the maintenance. We must check the tightness of the bolt of the mechanism, as well as power connections and earth connection. By fully closing the isolator, we need to check the whether all the male contacts properly enter in the female contacts or not. If we find abnormalities, we must adjust it immediately. Then we have to check whether the mechanical interlock is working properly or not. That means we have to try closing the earthing switch. After closing the isolator, if it is not possible physically, then we can ensure that mechanical interlocking is all right. Otherwise, we need to check the mechanism and rectify it. Then we need to lubricate the shaft bearing assembly, including mechanically leakage or auxiliary switches. We may apply a thin layer of conductive lubricant on the contacts, the auxiliary switches. We need to check the tightness of all the electrical control connection in the mechanism box. Also, we need to check the functionality of the all auxiliary relay in the mechanism box. We should to measure the contact resistance of each contact of each phase. We may use a digital ohm meter for this purpose. And lastly, we must check the electrical interlocking scheme of the each isolator and circuit breaker come under the interlocking scheme of that isolator. Then next we have to check the maintenance of the earthing switch. In that, we must check the alignment of the earthing blades. Also, we clean the blades including the female contacts of the switch. Then we need to check the aluminium and copper flexible bonds of the earthing switch. If we find any defect, we should replace those without going for repairing, because we should not compromise with the connection to the earth. We also need to check for the proper tightness of the earthing connection of the supporting structure and mechanism box. We need to visualize the check the contacts, clean the control terminals in the marshalling coaxes. The space heater plays a significant role in the marshalling coaxes because it keeps the inner space of the coax moisture free. So proper checking of the healthiness of the space heater in the marshalling coax is essential. If we find any defects in the door gaskets of the coax, we must repair or replace to avoid the rainwater enter in the coax. These are the different types of maintenance we have to carry out on the switchgear equipments. Thank you, friends.